Welcome back to the PJ Chain Design. Today we are looking to how to create this spiral decoration for an oval cabochon pendant. Are you ready? Let's get started. We're going to start at the top view, creating a sphere over there. And this will be the stone we want to create. Let's go ahead to make them into the oval. Then we want to coming over again to the top view and creating a box on the bottom half of the oval. And let's go ahead to use a boolean difference, this one out of this one. So then we can get this cabochon, depends on how thin or how thick it there. You can do 1D scale if you want to. Now we need to duplicate it, find out how big of this one so we can make a bezel. I'm going to turn that into red colors easier for you to see. Now we have something there. I simply just want to creating a profile. It looks something like this. And that will be our bezel. I'm going to create another one. Make sure smart track is on and so I can align with it. So let's go ahead to close this guy and join them. So now I have this. It's two way I can creating a bezel over here. If I use the rail revolve, it's gonna be the profile. This will be the rail and the axis will starting from a zero and up. And then you will get something like that. It look fine, but you also notice here on the top is much thicker than the one on the side over here. So I'm going to do another way, moving the top on the side for the comparison. We're going to use the sweep one. You're gonna have the rail and the cross section. So that way you can maintain the same thickness both on the top and on the side. So both will work, just the one on the right side, if it oval shape better. Okay, the second thing is we need to create that twisting element right there. So I'm going to, again, if you scale this up, you're going to notice the top is going to be thicker because it's proportion in scale. So instead of using the scale, I'm going to use the offset. I'm going to click on this one and we want to offset it for 1.5 millimeter. So something like this, we can scale it down if it is too much. But basically what I wanted to do is create an element that can flow around this area. So I'm gonna use that curve and use the helix. Right here on the top, you have a rounded curve. Let's click on this and depends on how many turns you want. In my case, I have 10 turns there. And then I'm gonna coming over to the top view, kind of decided how big of the turn that is going to be. So the bigger you have larger diameter, of course, on the twist. Next things we wanted to do is we need to creating cross section. So I'm gonna use the rectangle and make sure starting from the center and roughly doing something like this. So we can give it a try and see how it goes and adjust from there. I'm gonna use the sweep to command. This is rail one, rail two, and I want to record a history and click on the cross section. And as you can see, it's getting really, really thin over there. But since we have a record history, so a few things that we can try here. So first, we can try to make it a little bit wider. So then you won't have that thing. It can only stretch into a certain degree. You may see this getting really knife edges there because of the twist. So be really careful if you do that. The second thing is we can also, let me move it back, it's easier for you to see. We can kind of moving our cross section. So you may have the tighter inside and, you know, different kind of a pattern coming out, depends on how you like it. So I'm gonna state it right here, just make it a little bit thicker. You can also change the position, maybe make them a little bit taller. So you're gonna have this kind of twist. Be careful, that may be like twisting too sharp on the edges and some of them is overlapping. So be really careful if it is off center. So I'm just gonna go back there. And let's say this is what I like. I'm going to stay with this one. Now, after I do it, if I feel like I really don't like this triangle area, and this is an area we try to avoid when we do the casting, because those little triangle area might creating a casting porosity. So we might want to kind of scale it down so they can hiding inside of the bezel. All we wanted to have is twisting element right there. Again, let's do the helix around the curve. Instead of having 10, maybe I just want to have 6 of them to see what is the difference. Let's do a little bit comparison right here. So I'm going to have a 6 of them, and then you are going to sweep 2, rail 1, rail 2, cross section, and you will get something like this. Alright, so you don't have to always get like a lot, and then you can scale it down again to avoid some casting problem. Let's turn on the render view to take a look on it, and you might notice some of the surface is really, really zigzag and uneven surface. It doesn't tell much on our ghost view. You can kind of see a little bit, but it's not really clear there. The problem like this, it may have two reasons. First of all, is this is too long and it's passing, as you can see, it's passing that curve over there. What you can do is just make them a little bit shorter. It is inside of that diameter, so that point is not being repeated showing up. I also like to do is fit it the corners. Instead, we'll try to fit the edges on the solid. So I'm going to pick up this one, and let's pick up the fitted corners. And we are going to do something really small, 0.15, it's fine. So let's take a look again. We're going to use the sweep to rail, rail 1 and rail 2 and cross section. And then let's turn on the render view. And this get much smoother surface. Okay, so if you get what I just had, maybe you just having a too big of the cross section. Again, we try to avoid this triangle area. So what we wanted to do is kind of scale this down, hiding it inside of the bezel. And don't forget to close the bottom. And don't forget to close the bottom. So what I like to do is pick up this curve and have it extrude it straight going to the bottom, and we can bowling those two. I usually like to have this decoration touching the ground, so I might want to just 1D scale with the gumball. On the top they look the same, but on the side it just look much better. It's touching the same button. After that, you can fit the edges and adding the bell, adding the chin. So this will be great for the rendering. Lamo video is for the members only. If you haven't joined the membership, consider to join it. Not only you support my work and also help other people to learn Rhino. Hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching and see you next.